mga hinigugma diha ni Kristo. I look forward to celebrating the Mass of the Divine Mercy at the Chapel, the Divine Mercy Chapel in Garing Consolacion. I know that there will only be very few in the chapel, but I also believe that there may be hundreds or perhaps a thousand who would be following us through radio broadcast or live stream. In this regard, I'd like to say dagan kayong salamat to you, the Living Church, who manifest the faith in an active way even with COVID-19. This Sunday, the octave of Easter, is known as the Divine Mercy Sunday. This feast was instituted by Saint John Paul II in 2000 during the canonization of Santa Faustina, the secretary and apostle of God's mercy. From the diary of Saint Faustina, we read about Jesus instructing her, "Tell the whole world about my inconceivable mercy. I desire that the feast of mercy be a refuge and shelter for all souls, and especially for poor sinners. On that day, the very depths of my tender mercy are open. It is my desire that it be solemnly celebrated on the first Sunday after Easter. Mankind will not have peace until it turns to the fount of mercy." My dear brothers and sisters, from today's Gospel reading, we are invited to reflect on the experience of Thomas the Apostle. He said, "Unless I have seen his hands and the print of the nails, and put my finger in the mark of the nails, and my hand on his side, I will not believe." This was when the apostles recounted that they have seen the risen Lord. And in the Gospel, when Jesus appeared to the apostles, he asked Thomas to put his finger on his side. And Thomas said, "My Lord and my God." And Jesus said, "You believe because you have seen, but blessed are those who have not seen and yet believe." Mga hinigugma, as we gather and as we celebrate the Feast of the Divine Mercy, we thank the Lord for the gift of faith. We believe in Jesus and we put our trust in Him. And because we trust Jesus, we bring to the Lord, especially this day, our intentions and our ardent prayers. Most obvious of which is that we may be healed of this pandemic we call COVID. Lately, the song "Heal Our Land" by Jimmy Rivera, rendered in Tagalog, "Hilumin Mo Kami," has been most popular. Thank you for participating also in the Healing Rosary, first in Manila, then here in Cebu, next in Antipolo, and then last Wednesday in Lingayen de Gupan. As the song "Heal Our Land" says, "When we humble ourselves." In Tagalog, it says, "Kung tayo'y maniniklohod, then we expect healing from the Lord." My dear friends, may I also invite all of you participating in today's fiesta celebration. As I am aware how much we need healing from COVID, but perhaps we need to take a look whether we also have a need of healing in other aspects of our Christian life, like healing of our moral and spiritual life, the healing of relationship, healing of emotions, healing of vices, of memories, and of many social and communal ills. Saint Faustina referred to the mercy of God as unfathomable, immeasurable, infinite, limitless. not just a stream or river, but an ocean, so vast and boundless, so deep, it never runs dry. Let us not doubt. Let us not hesitate to bring to Jesus our many needs. His love is unfathomable and everlasting. Today, on the Feast of Divine Mercy, we also remember and we honor the great apostles of Divine Mercy, Saint Faustina and Saint John Paul II. As we pray that in the near future, the statue of Divine Mercy will rise on top of the hill in Barangay Garing, Consolacion. Now it is time that we first live the life or the spirituality of the Divine Mercy, the ABC, if you want to simplify it. A, ask for mercy. B, be merciful to others. C, complete trust in Jesus. Yes, to continually ask for God's mercy, for as Jesus said, I pour out a whole ocean of graces upon those souls who approach the fount of my mercy. Pope Francis likewise said, mercy is the true power that can save humanity and the world from sin and evil. Then, experiencing God's mercy, we are exhorted to be merciful to others. This time of COVID, we can think of 101 ways to show mercy. Even staying at home, social distancing, respect or acts of charity and support to the frontliners, the doctors, the nurses, respect to government officials, military personnel. And yes, today, how much barangay lose need for our support and assistance. C, complete trust in Jesus. As Pope Francis said, my Christ is risen. In his glorious body, he bears indelible wounds. Wounds that have become windows of hope. Let us turn our gaze to him that he may heal the wounds of afflicted humanity. Yes, my friends, how beautiful, how hopeful it would be that after COVID, we start constructing the statue of Divine Mercy. It will be an assurance for us that flowing from the wounded side of Jesus, the blood of the Eucharist, and the water of new life of baptism will sustain and protect Cebu, the Cebu we love, and all devotees of the Divine Mercy. We recite the chaplet. We encourage people to have devotion to the Divine Mercy and more. Today, we pledge to live in communion, not in isolation, in collaboration and not in separation. We think of the common good and not just of individual welfare. We act with inclusivity and not exclusivity. We become part of the solution and not add to the problem. Dear friends, when I think of tomorrow, of next year, of the fifth centenary of Christianity, of the first Mass and first baptism, freed from fear and living in trust and freedom, I think of Cebu giving birth to two new daughter dioceses. And I think of clergy, religious, and lay faithful working in cooperation, in synodality, grateful for the many gifts and sharing our giftedness. Because we all believe in the Divine Mercy, and because we put our trust in Jesus, we can pray with Pope Francis, Lord, may you bless the world, give health to our bodies and comfort our hearts. You ask us not to be afraid. Yet our faith is weak and we are fearful. But you, Lord, will not leave us at the mercy of the storm. Loving Father, for the sake of the sorrowful passion of Jesus, your beloved Son, have mercy on us and the whole world. Amen. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.